Hi, boys and girls. How are you doing today on the Sunday? Thank you for joining us at our very fun online children's church. So I just wanted to show you my favorite scarf, and it's my favorite scarf because I love these colors, but a very special friend gave it to me for my birthday. Girls, do you have a favorite skirt or a dress or something very special, maybe even a scrunchie, and you feel very special when you wear it? And sometimes your friends even say, "Ooh, that's beautiful. I wish I had one too." Sorry, boys. You don't really mind about skirts and dresses. Maybe you boys have got a fancy tie that you like. Ugh, I'm only kidding. I know you boys don't really wear ties anymore these days. Maybe you have a special hoodie or a great pair of sneakers that you can go cross country or cycling in. But we each have something special that we love to wear that makes us feel really good when we wear it, don't we? It's like our special outfit. Today's story is about a very special coat of many colors. Jacob was Joseph's dad. Jacob had 12 sons. And he loved all of them, but he loved Joseph the best because Joseph was born when Jacob was very, very old. Morgi, won't you please? Thank you. So Jacob wanted to make Joseph something very special to show him that he was his favorite son. So he started off making him a beautiful coat of many colors.
Look handsome, I look smart. I am a walking work of art. Such a dazzling coat of many colors. How I love my coat of many colors.
It was red and yellow and green and brown, scarlet and black and ochre and peach and ruby and olive and violet and gold.
I look handsome, I look smart. I am a walking work of art. Such a dazzling coat of many colors. How I love my coat of many colors.
It was red and yellow and green and brown, scarlet and black and ochre and peach and ruby and olive and violet and gold.
Joseph's brothers were starting to get a little bit jealous with all of this fancy, beautiful material to make him a beautiful coat, and they weren't getting one. Weren't you? All these beautiful colors going into a beautiful coat for one of the brothers. Not everybody, just the one. Just Joseph. Well, the brothers started to feel very jealous towards Joseph. A few days later, Jacob told Joseph to go and look in the fields and see if the other brothers were okay because they were tending to the sheep. So Joseph said, "Sure, Dad, I'll go and check that they're fine." And off he went. As he started approaching, the brothers saw him and started to make plans to kill him. "Let's kill him and throw him into a ditch and pretend he was eaten by wild animals. Won't you bring me another one, please?" Reuben, who was the oldest brother, had mercy on Joseph, but he couldn't tell the other brothers. So he tried to come up with a plan, and he said, "I know, let's not kill him. Let's just put him in this pit and he will just die naturally." But actually Reuben had a plan. He was going to come past later to rescue Joseph when the other brothers weren't looking, because he decided this didn't sound like such a good plan. "I think we need another piece for our lovely cloak. Can you please?" So Joseph was on his way closer and closer towards them. And when he arrived, the brothers grabbed him. They ripped his coat off and they threw him into this pit. And then do you know what they did? they sat down and had supper. It's very weird, isn't it? But they were eating their supper. It was actually a good thing, because as they sat and ate, and Joseph was stuck in the pit, they saw people in the far distance, a caravan of merchants. They were slave traders traveling through the desert towards Egypt, where there was a huge big city, and they had markets to sell their goods and do the whole slave trade thing. So they came past. Pass me another one of those things. Well, the brothers thought to themselves, we don't get anything if we kill our brother. I know, why don't we sell him and get some money to these slave traders? So they all decided that that would be a good thing. And of course, Reuben thought, well, at least then my brother won't be killed. And they pulled him up out of the pit and they sold him for 20 pieces of silver to the merchants traveling to Egypt. Pass us another one of those things, please. So the brothers began to make up a story that they would tell their father. They killed a goat and they rubbed some blood all over Joseph's beautiful technicolored coat. And they devised a story that they would tell their father Jacob once they all got home. They said, a wild creature must have eaten Joseph, because look, Dad, we found his beautiful coat full of blood. He must have died out in the wilderness while he was coming to find us. Jacob was very, very sad. He was mad and angry and confused, and he's like, what? He held onto the beautiful coat and he said, my son, pass us another one quick. I think you're right. I think a ferocious animal must have eaten my precious Joseph. Well, I'm sure you agree that it was a very terrible thing that brothers could have done to another brother. And just because they were jealous of him. I hope that none of us ever do anything like that, as terrible as what the brothers did to Joseph. But we can learn from the Bible, and we can learn from the story, that jealousy causes you to do lots of ugly things. And the Bible also tells us that Joseph's brothers were loved by their dad. They were greedy and wanted the same love that he had for Joseph. And we can sort of understand it, but it cannot push you to do something so terrible just because you're jealous of somebody. In fact, they should have been happy that their father loved them and rather looked at all of the things that they did that was great, that the talents that they had and the love that they could share with each other and the good points they had in common with each other, instead of just focusing on the fact that they didn't have a fancy coat. We really should be happy with ourselves, because Jesus made us and he loves us. And he lives inside our hearts. Now look at this beautiful arrangement. I'm going to make a coat. Do you think that's a good idea? With all these beautiful technicolored pieces that you guys collected and gave? I wonder if it's as beautiful as Joseph's coat. Let's see if we can put it together. But I just want to tell you, it sounds a little bit rough, the story. I've got to tell you, it does have a happy ending. So you must stick around, come again next Sunday, that you can listen to the rest of this beautiful story about Joseph and his beautiful colored coat. But more, it's Joseph and his love and trust in God. So there's a happy ending, and I hope you have a great week. Let's just close our eyes and say a prayer. Dear Lord Jesus, we thank you for this day. We thank you that you love each and every one of us. Help us not to feel jealous of others. Help us to be happy with ourselves, with the way you made us, that we do our best, and that we can shine for you, and that we can love each other the way you love us. Lord, we pray these things in your precious name. Amen.
Joseph was loved very much by his dad, but this made all of his brothers really, really mad. Yeah, really, really mad. So his brothers got together and came up with a plan to sell Joseph to a far-off land. This land was Egypt. He was made into a slave, but everyone he worked for liked how he behaved. They liked how he behaved. God was with Joseph, even in this far-off land. He works all things for good because he always has a plan. The Pharaoh ended up making Joseph second in command, and Joseph had to store food to feed the whole land. A famine came, that means there was no food to eat, and Joseph's brothers longed for wheat, meat, or a tiny treat. But Egypt was doing fine because of what Joseph had done. People everywhere came for food, even his brothers came for some. They didn't recognize who Joseph had become. It had been many years since the bad things they had done. He revealed who he was to his brothers, and they were scared of the punishment that they deserved. But Joseph forgave them instead of being.